Good morning, dear students. Last class, we have completed one chapter of the chemistry and I have given you the homeworks. I think you have done all the homeworks. It will be checked when your school will be reopened. Now today, we start physics, chapter 10, reflection and refraction of light. Before going to the chapter, reflection and refraction, we should know something about light. What is light? Light is a form of energy which is cause of sensation of vision. Means, suppose at night you are sitting in a room with some of your family member. Suddenly load shedding. Can you see your member? Certainly not. You have the visibility, but you cannot see, because without light, we cannot see anything. So it is said that light is a sensation of vision. Light is invisible. We cannot see the light, but when light falls on any object and from that particular object it is reflected and entering in our eyes, so we can see. How I can see you? When light falls on your body and from your body light reflected and entering in my eyes. Similarly, how you can see me? Because when light falls on me and after reflection, it is goes to your eyes. Same process, when light falls on a wall of the room, we can see. When lights fall on a chair, we can see the chair, and so on. Light always travels in an enormous speed in vacuum. That is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Light is a electromagnetic radiation. Radiation are two types. One is electromagnetic radiation, one is non-electromagnetic radiation. Non-electromagnetic radiation requires a certain medium for its propagation. As for example, heat requires a certain medium to flow from one path to another path. Electricity require a conductor to move from one place to the another place. But light need not reach any material medium for its propagation. So it is an electromagnetic radiation. Light always travels in a straight line. This property of the light is known as rectilinear propagations of light. Before going to the chapter of the reflection and refraction, we should know something about the ray of light and beam of light. As I have told you, light always travels in a straight line. That means light have a particular direction for its propagation. The path or particular directions on which light is propagated, this particular path of direction is known as beam of light. And when maximum beam of light, two or more than two beam of light combining together, then they are said to be beam of light. Maximum ray of light is combining together, then they are said to be beam of light. So we can say ray of light is a part of beam of light, and combination of the ray of light is a beam of light. There are three types of the beam of light. One is parallel beam of light, one is converging beam of light, one is diverging beam of light. Everything I will explain you in this chapter. In this chapter, we will also read, except the reflection and refraction, some attractive phenomena related to the reflection and refraction. Suppose the twinkling of the star, how the rainbow has been formed. Why the clear sky looks blue? This all we'll discuss in this chapter. In this chapter, we'll also discuss the mirror and different types of the mirror and parts of the mirror. Gradually, in the next class, we'll start. Today, your homework is read the introductions of chapter 10. Thank you.